Hello, welcome to Dental Digest Plus. Please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so you can get the regular updates. In previous lecture, we learned about the properties of dental wax. Now one by one, let's learn about the waxes used in dentistry in detail. First, pattern waxes. They are used in the construction of the metal casting for dentures through the lost wax technique. Inlay wax, casting wax, and baseplate wax, these are the pattern waxes used in dentistry. Now first, let's take a look at the inlay wax. The main constituent usually present in inlay casting wax are paraffin wax, beeswax, and carding wax. 60% of the inlay wax is made out of a paraffin wax. This is a mineral wax derived from the petroleum. Paraffin wax is brittle at ambient temperature, therefore it flakes when carved rather than giving a smooth surface. It exhibits a volume contraction between 11 to 15% during solidification from molten stage. Therefore, we use beeswax, which decreases the brittleness at room temperature, it prevents flaking, and it improves the carving properties. Carnauba wax is added to obtain the suitable melting ranges and glass transition temperature. They also improve the adhesive qualities, smoothness, and prevent cracking. They may be replaced partially by synthetic resins. Inlay waxes are used to prepare patterns. Type 1 is a medium wax, which is employed in direct techniques of wax adaptation. And type 2 is a soft wax, which is used in the indirect technique of wax adaptation. Inlay wax must exhibit excellent adaptability to model or a die surface, and it must be free from distortion, flaking, or chipping during the preparation of patterns. Inlay waxes may be softened over a flame or into the water at 54 degree to 60 degree centigrade, and it is done to enable their flow in liquid state and for their proper adaptation to the prepared tooth or a die surface. For direct wax technique, type 1 inlay wax must be softened at a temperature which is not hazardous to the pulp tissue, and it must be hardened at a temperature above the mouth temperature. Inlay waxes maintains the uniform workability, and the adaptation of the inlay wax to tooth or die is very accurate. A regular or soft type of inlay wax is typically used for indirect work at room temperature or in cool weather. A harder or medium type with low flow property is indicated for the use in the warmer climates. Now let's see how indirect technique is used with inlay waxes. First, the cavity is prepared in the tooth. After that, impression of that prepared tooth along with the remaining teeth is taken. After that, die is made out of an impression of the prepared tooth. Then the pattern is carved directly on a die, which is the reproduction of the prepared tooth and the dental tissues. A pattern made by indirect method may not shrink as much as it shrinks into the direct technique. Now let's take a look at the direct technique. First, the cavity is prepared in a tooth. Then a wax pattern is made in a mouth for producing the wax pattern within the prepared teeth. Because thermal expansion coefficient of the wax is extremely high compared with the values of the other dental materials, a wax pattern made into the mouth by direct technique will shrink as it is cooled to the room temperature. Now let's talk about the flow of the inlay wax. One of the desirable properties of type 1 inlay wax is that it should have a flow at a temperature slightly above that of the mouth. Each wax exhibits a sharp transition temperature at which it loses its plasticity. Soft inlay wax exhibits a transition point at a lower temperature than hard inlay wax. The wax lacks rigidity and may flow under the applied pressure, even at a room temperature. Requirements for the flow properties of inlay waxes at a specific temperature are: the maximum flow permitted for the type 1 inlay waxes at a 37 degree centigrade is around at 1%, because at the level of oral temperature, there should be no distortion of the wax pattern, and their flow at the temperature permits carving. Flow of the wax at this temperature should permit carving and removal of the pattern from the prepared cavity. In addition to that, both type 1 and type 2 inlay waxes at the 45 degree centigrade must have a minimum flow of 70% and the maximum flow of 90%. So, in general, at the temperature of 37 degree centigrade, the maximum flow should be 1%, and at 45 degree centigrade, the maximum flow should be at 90 degree centigrade. Now let's talk about the thermal properties of inlay wax. The thermal conductivity of the inlay waxes is low, and sufficient time must be allowed both to heat them uniformly and to cool them at the body temperature. Another thermal characteristic of inlay wax is their high coefficient of thermal expansion. The temperature at which change in the thermal expansion rate occurs is known as the glass transition temperature. Some constituent of the wax probably change in their crystalline form at this temperature, and the wax is more plastic at higher temperature. Now let's take a look at the manipulation of inlay waxes. Waxes oxidize on heating, and on prolonged heating, some of the waxes evaporate, so that the storage container for melted wax will be coated by gummy deposits. Therefore, care should be taken to use the lowest temperature possible and to clean the wax pot and replace the wax periodically. To manipulate inlay wax, dry heat is preferred to use than a water bath. If we use water bath to manipulate wax, it could result in the inclusion of droplets of water, which can smear the wax surface during polishing and distort the pattern during the temperature changes. So, to manipulate the inlay wax, dry heat is preferred. To avoid distortion during removal of the wax pattern, it should be penetrated slightly with an explorer point and carefully removed from the cavity. After removal, touching the wax pattern with the fingers should be avoided as much as possible to prevent any temperature changes and distortion. To fabricate indirect patterns, the die should be lubricated, preferably with the lubricant containing wetting agent. The melted wax may be added in layers with a spatula or waxing instrument. The prepared cavity should be overfilled and the wax is then carved to the proper contour. A silk or other fine cloth may be used for the final polishing of the wax pattern. Some clinicians prefer to apply finger pressure as the wax is cooling to help fill the cavity and prevent distortion during the cooling procedure. The fingers also accelerates the cooling rate. Regardless of the method chosen, the most practical method for avoiding the possible delayed distortion is to invest the pattern immediately after removal from the mouth or die. Once the investment hardens, no distortion of the pattern will occur. Now let's take a look at the wax distortion. Distortion of the wax pattern results from the occluded air into the wax pattern. Physical distortion of the pattern. Release of stresses during the previous cooling of the wax. Excessive storage time of the wax pattern. And extreme temperature changes during storage of the wax pattern. Because waxes tend to return partially to their original shape after manipulation, it is very important for the wax pattern to be retained on the die for several hours to avoid the distortion and to ensure that equilibrium conditions are established. To demonstrate this effect, a stick of inlay wax can be softened over a burner and it is bent into the horseshoe shape and it is chilled into this position. If it is floated into the room temperature water for number of hours, the horseshoe will open. When the wax is bent into the horseshoe shape, the inner molecules are under compression and the outer ones are in tension. Once the stresses are gradually relieved at room temperature, the wax tends to recover its elastic strain. Storage of the wax pattern for too long can lead to the distortion of its form because of the stresses relaxation effects. A casting will fit most accurately when the pattern is invested immediately after removal from the preparation. Now let's take a look at the base plate wax. It is used to establish the initial arch form in the construction of a complete dentures. It is supplied in 1 to 2 mm thick red or pink sheets. In composition of base plate wax, paraffin wax is around 70 to 80%, beeswax is around 12%, carnauba wax is around 2.5%, resin is 3%, and synthetic waxes are 2.5%. The harder the wax, the less is the flow at the given temperature. The difference in the flow of the three types may be advantageous for the particular application. Type 1 base plate wax is a soft wax and it is used for building veneers. Type 2 base plate wax is a medium wax and it is designed for the patterns to be placed inside the patient's mouth in normal climatic conditions. Type 3 base plate wax is a hard wax and it is used for trial fitting inside the patient's mouth in tropical climates. Uses of the base plate wax. To establish the vertical dimension, plane of occlusion and initial arch form in the technique for the complete denture restoration. To form the entire tray or the portion of the tray itself. It is used to produce the desired contour of the denture after teeth are set in position. Base plate wax is also called modeling wax. Now let's talk about the casting waxes. They are used to construct the metal framework of the partial and complete dentures. Casting waxes are supplied in the form of sheets and they are also supplied into the preformed shapes. The physical properties are similar to the inlay wax except the melting range. The melting range is only important for laboratory procedure because these waxes are not softened inside the patient's mouth. Casting waxes are used for thin sections of certain removable and fixed partial denture patterns. These waxes are available in the form of sheets, usually 28 and 30 gauge thicknesses. And it is available in bulk. Now let's see classification of the casting wax. For class 1, it is of 28 gauge and it is pink in color. Flow of the wax is around 10% at 35 degrees centigrade and it is easily adaptable at 40 to 45 degrees centigrade. For class 2, it is of 30 gauge and it is green in color. Minimum flow of the wax is 60% at 38 degrees centigrade. It adapts well onto the surface and it is not brittle on cooling. For class 3, it is of ready-made shapes and it is blue in color. It will burn out at 500 degrees centigrade, leaving no carbon residue, and it is used to produce the metallic component of the partial denture on the cast. Up until now, we talked about the inlay wax, baseplate wax and casting waxes, and these were the pattern waxes that are used in dentistry. Now we will talk about the processing waxes. Processing waxes are used primarily to aid in the dental procedure, both clinically and in laboratory. Boxing wax, utility wax and sticky wax, these are the processing waxes used in dentistry. Now first, let's talk about the sticky wax. It is the type of a processing wax. It is sticky when melted with maximum 5% of flow at 30 degrees centigrade and 90% at 43 degrees centigrade, and it adheres closely to the surfaces when it is applied to it. If any kind of movement occurs into the wax pattern, the wax tends to fracture rather than distort. At the room temperature, the wax is firm and it is free from tackiness and it is very brittle. Uses of the sticky waxes are: it is used to align the fracture parts of the acrylic dentures. It is used to align the fixed partial denture units before soldering. Now let's talk about the utility wax. It is type of the processing wax. It is supplied in the form of sticks and seeds. It is orange or dark red in color. Flow of the utility wax at 37.5 degrees centigrade is minimum 65% and maximum 80%, and it is pliable and tacky at the 21 to 24 degrees centigrade temperature. A standard perforated tray for the use with hydrocolloids may easily be brought to a more desirable contour by utility wax. It can be used to alter the stock tray extensions. Now let's talk about the boxing and beading waxes. It is the type of the processing wax. Boxing wax is supplied as seeds and beading wax is supplied as strips. Use of the boxing and beading waxes are: beading wax is adapted around the impression border to create the land area of the cast, and it will preserve the height and width of the sulcus. Boxing wax is used to build up the vertical wall around the impression in order to pour the gypsum product and to make the base of the cast. Now let's talk about the impression waxes. They are used to obtain the impression of the oral structures. Corrective impression waxes and bite registration waxes are the impression waxes used in dentistry. First, we will see the corrective wax. Wax in combination with resin of low melting point can be used in corrective impression technique in partial and complete denture prosthesis. The peculiarity of the impression wax is that they flow at mouth temperature. It is available in the form of seeds and cakes. It is used as a wax veneer over an original impression to contact and register the details of the soft tissue. Now let's talk about the bite registration wax. It is used to record the relationship of the upper and lower teeth in dentulous patients. Wax is softened under the hot running water. After that, full arch, a quadrant, or just few teeth can be taken into the impression with the help of bite registration wax. Into the last part of the lecture, let me tell you the methods of softening the wax. First is water bath. Second is a flame of Bunsen and burner. Third is an infrared lamp. Fourth is a wax annealer.